going to find the values of p for which the given improper integral converges. So the first thing to do is to write the limit notation as r approaches 0 from the right. And how do I know that this is what I should write for the limit? Notice that the troublesome value for x is 0, right? So 3 divided by 0 cannot happen, right? It's not allowed, it's undefined. So we have to bring the limit as r approaches 0 from the right, because the 0 is the leftmost limit, right? So you have to approach 0 from the right, right, away from 1, right? So we're going to have from r to 1, 3. Now we're going to write x to the negative p so that we eliminate the fraction and can view this so that we use the power rule of the antiderivative to find the antiderivative, right? So now we're going to have what? The power increases by 1, so it's going to be negative p plus 1 in the antiderivative as the power of x. So negative p plus 1 is the same as 1 minus p, right? So we're going to have limit as r approaches 0 from the right, 3 x raised to the 1 minus p power. And also remember, you have to divide by that resulting power as well, using following the power rule of the antiderivative. Evaluated from r to 1. So now we can write this even simpler. We can take out the 3 and 1 minus p outside and write the limit as r approaches 0 from the right of x to the 1 minus p, evaluated from r to 1. So now let's play around with the values of p and see where we get convergence. So first case, p is greater than 1. Let's do that. If p is greater than 1, what is going to happen? If p is greater than 1, then what is 1 minus p going to be? 1 minus p is going to be less than 0. Because if you subtract p on both sides of this inequality, you will get 1 minus p is less than 0. Okay? So 1 minus p is less than 0, which means this whole thing is negative. Right, so we're going to treat this as negative. Okay, and then let's see what we're going to have. We're going to have 1 to the 1 minus p minus r to the 1 minus p. Okay, so 1 minus p is less than 0. So we have to actually rewrite this part as 1 over r and then negate 1 minus p, p minus 1. How do I know that? If 1 minus p is less than 0, having a negative in the power flips, right? It will flip the r essentially, right? So it's not going to be r to the 1 minus p, it's going to be 1 over the r. And also the power is negated because you're talking about the denominator, right? So for example, x to the negative second, I'm going to give you this as a note, is written as 1 over x, and also the negated power becomes a 2. Right? So that's why it's p minus 1, it's negated. Negate the 1 minus p, it will be p minus 1. Right? So this is essentially what we're looking at. So this is negative. And then what are we going to have here? 1 to the negative is still 1, right? So 1 minus 1 over, and let's see, 0 is this, right? 0. Now p minus 1 is going to be greater than 0, right? Because we're negating. So 0 to the positive is still 0, right? So this is going to be what? This is going to be 1 minus, 1 over 0 is infinity, right? And since this is negative and negative infinity, plus 1 is still negative infinity. Negative infinity times the negative is positive infinity, right? So what does that tell you? Divergence. So the given improper integral diverges for p values exceeding 1. Now let's try p is equal to 1. We're going to circle this one because this part here is relevant only when p is greater than 1, right? When you flip the fraction. So here, we're going to use this part. But for p is equal to 1, we're not going to use this part. We're going to rather go back to the original integral. Okay, we're going to have this. We're going to have 3x to the negative 1, right? So we're substituting the p-value 1 into the original integral. So basically what we're going to have is we're going to have 3, the limit as r approaches 0 from the right, from r to 1, 1 over x dx, right? Because x to the negative 1 is the same thing as 1 over x. So what is that going to give us? That's going to give us, as r approaches 0 from the right, we're going to have ln, right? But yeah, the 3 is already there, so ln of x evaluated from r to 1. And I'm doing absolute value because remember that the inputs for the ln's must be positive and above, right? So positive, not 0 or negative. That's why there's an absolute value. So now let's play around and see what happens. So we will have the limit as r approaches 0 from the right. We will have ln of 1 minus ln of r, right? Using the fundamental theorem of calculus. So now we're going to have what? We're going to have ln of 1 minus ln of 0. Now ln of 0 is what? Negative infinity, right? Negative infinity. So what does that give you? Ln of 1 is 0. Negative infinity times the negative number is positive infinity. So positive infinity plus 0 is infinity, plus times 3 is infinity. So what? Look what happens. There's still the same result. There's still divergence when p is equal to 1 as well. Right? So now p has to be probably less than 1 for convergence, but let's check that. Let's check the case when it's less than 1. If p is less than 1, 1 minus p this time is going to be greater than 0, right? Because if to transform into this inequality, you have to subtract p on both sides. 1 minus p is going to be greater than 0 as a result, right? So that, let's now write this part. So that means 3 over 1 minus p is going to be greater than 0, right? So this whole thing will be positive, so we'll take a note of that. So using this now, we're going to have what? We're going to have 1 to the 1 minus p minus r to the 1 minus p. Notice now we're not using 1 over r to the p minus 1 because 1 minus p exceeds 0. So whenever you have 1 minus p as the positive power, the r would stay there. It would not be flipped to become 1 over r because the exponent is positive, right? So it's going to be just r to the 1 minus p. And also notice there's no negation because we're staying without the fraction. So it's just 1 minus p as opposed to p minus 1 in the forming case. So now let's see what's going to happen. So this thing, what was positive, as we've noted, and what does this become? 1 to the 1 minus p is still 1 minus, and then 0 to the positive, right? Because this thing is positive, 1 minus p. 0 raised to the positive power is still 0, right? So look what happens. 3 to the 1 minus p. So this is the value to which the improper integral converges to for p values being less than 1. Okay, so convergent p values. Okay, these are the convergent p values for which the convergent value of the improper integral, I'm just going to add improper integral, converges to. Okay, to this value. 4 p values being less than 1. Thanks for watching. Thanks. Hope this was fun, and see you in the next video.